Hello and welcome to this session. My name is Haytham Mekawi, and today we will talk about asthma. Asthma is a chronic yet reversible inflammatory disorder of the airways, characterized by three main features: bronchial hyperresponsiveness, episodic bronchospasm, and increased mucus production accompanied by mucosal edema. In its most severe form, known as status asthmaticus, the patient experiences life-threatening airway obstruction that does not respond to initial bronchodilator therapy. From a pathophysiological standpoint, asthma involves constriction of bronchial smooth muscle, reducing airway diameter, and increasing resistance. Activation of inflammatory cells, especially eosinophils and mast cells. Increased mucus production, worsening obstruction. This leads to ventilation perfusion mismatch, causing hypoxemia. Progressive air trapping results in dynamic hyperinflation, raising the work of breathing. In chronic cases, a late phase inflammatory response may lead to airway remodeling, further complicating long-term management. Patients with asthma typically present with dyspnea, wheezing, and prolonged expiration. Initially, they exhibit tachypnea and tachycardia, often relying on accessory muscles for breathing. As the condition worsens, the patient may become hypoxemic, displaying confusion or agitation. A silent chest, where no breath sounds are heard, is a grave warning sign indicating near complete airway obstruction. Arterial blood gases evolve. In early stages, low carbon dioxide levels with respiratory alkalosis. In late stages, carbon dioxide retention and respiratory acidosis, signaling imminent respiratory failure. Asthma must be distinguished from other causes of airway compromise. In adults, common mimics include chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, anaphylaxis, pulmonary embolism, vocal cord dysfunction. In children, consider bronchiolitis, foreign body aspiration, trachomalacia, mediastinal masses. Intraoperatively, differential considerations include light anesthesia, endobronchial intubation, endotracheal tube obstruction or kinking. Preoperative assessment. A thorough preoperative evaluation includes determining asthma control. Ask about the frequency of symptoms and use of rescue inhalers. Note any prior intubations or ICU admissions. Identify triggering factors such as allergens, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or beta blockers. Review pulmonary function tests, including peak expiratory flow rate and forced expiratory volume in 1 second. Preoperative optimization involves continuing all maintenance inhalers, particularly inhaled corticosteroids and long-acting beta agonists. Administering preoperative salbutamol, 2 to 4 puffs via metered dose inhaler or nebulization. Giving systemic corticosteroids if there was a recent exacerbation or history of oral steroid use. Intraoperative management. Induction. Ketamine is often preferred due to its bronchodilatory effects and preservation of spontaneous respiration. Propofol can be used as an alternative due to mild bronchodilation, though it may cause hypotension. Avoid histamine-releasing drugs such as morphine and atracurium. Airway strategy. When feasible, use a laryngeal mask airway to reduce airway stimulation. Use sevoflurane for maintenance. It has bronchodilatory properties. Ensure deep anesthesia during both intubation and extubation to avoid reflex bronchospasm. Anticholinergics like glycopyrrolate may reduce airway secretions. Bronchospasm management. If bronchospasm occurs, deepen anesthesia, deliver 100% oxygen, and ventilate manually. Administer inhaled salbutamol, 4 to 8 puffs through a spacer or endotracheal tube. Intravenous magnesium sulfate, 1 to 2 grams. Intravenous steroids such as hydrocortisone, 100 milligrams. Emergence. Extubate only when the patient is fully awake. Use gentle suctioning and closely monitor for post-extubation bronchospasm. Postoperative management: continue bronchodilators and inhaled or systemic corticosteroids. Provide humidified oxygen. Watch for delayed bronchospasm. Avoid non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs in aspirin-sensitive individuals. If the patient has obstructive sleep apnea or is fatigued, consider non-invasive ventilation such as continuous positive airway pressure. Asthma in the intensive care unit. status asthmaticus. In the ICU, status asthmaticus is managed using a stepwise approach. High flow oxygen target saturation between 94 and 98%. Nebulized salbutamol repeated doses of 2.5, 5 milligrams of continuous infusion. Nebulized ipratropium bromide, 0.5 milligrams every 20 minutes for 3 doses. Intravenous corticosteroids, hydrocortisone, 100 milligrams or methylprednisolone. Intravenous magnesium sulfate, 1.2 to 2 grams over 20 minutes. Intravenous salbutamol aminophylline, in refractory cases only. Mechanical ventilation for respiratory failure. Extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, EC mole last resort for refractory cases. Asthmatic patients requiring intubation need lung protective ventilation strategies. Use volume-controlled or pressure-controlled modes. Tidal volumes should be low, around 4 to 6 milliliters per kilogram of ideal body weight. Respiratory rate should also be low, ideally 8 to 10 breaths per minute. The inspiratory to expiratory ratio should be adjusted to allow a prolonged expiratory phase, up to 1 to 5. Apply minimal or zero positive end expiratory pressure to avoid auto-PP. Permissive hypercapnia is acceptable if arterial pH remains above 7.2. Monitoring for dynamic hyperinflation is essential. A sudden drop in blood pressure may indicate this complication. Disconnect the circuit and perform manual decompression of the lungs. Sedation, and in some cases, neuromuscular blockade may be needed to manage ventilator desynchrony. In children, the same principles apply with minor adjustments. Avoid airway stimulation at all stages. Use ketamine for induction due to its bronchodilating properties. Avoid desflurane, which can irritate the airway. Dosage for intravenous magnesium is 25 to 50 milligrams per kilogram, up to 2 grams. Hydrocortisone is dosed at 4 milligrams per kilogram every 6 hours. Extubate only when the child is fully awake with intact airway reflexes. Consider dexamethasone preoperatively at a dose of 0.15 to 0.6 milligrams per kilogram to reduce airway inflammation.